Blessings, fam, and welcome back to Inspirational Cafe. I'm your girl, Rochelle, here. I uplift, encourage, and I inspire. Don't forget to hit that like button. Don't forget to share, and please subscribe. This is Monday's Motivational Minute. Today, let's talk about the final say, for we know God is all-knowing, and God indeed has the final say, no matter what anyone else thinks, whatever anyone else speaks over our lives, we know God has the final say. God is all-knowing. God knew our ending before we ever knew our beginning, because he's all-knowing. And God finalizes. He finalizes all of our priorities, our hope, our plans, and our purpose. God finalizes everything in our lives. And God says, when you're feeling in despair and you're feeling lost, he promised he would never leave us desperate and he would never leave us alone. That's God's word. He said, I will never forsake you. I will never leave nor forsake you. That's God's word. That's his word. And even after we've been faced with so many disappointments, so many we can't even name them all. Frustrations and rejections, denials and delays. If you haven't had any, keep living. I can promise you, you will. After we've been faced with all of that, we still know that God has the final say. Even after we've been told no so many times, we know God has the final say. It doesn't matter what someone else thinks of you. God has the final say. We have to remember the promises of God. God says in Jeremiah 29 and 11, I know the plans. He says that I know the plans I have for you to prosper you, not to harm you, but to give you hope and a great future. That's God's word. So we have to remain faithful in believing and trusting that God has the final say, even after so many others have told us we're not qualified. They've told us that, no, we don't need you for this particular position. We found someone else. No, I don't think that we need you just yet. I don't think we're going to go forward into this project. God has already purposed you for greatness. So who are you going to believe? Are you going to believe the report of others? Or are you going to believe God's report? Because God indeed has the final say. Even right now in your temporary, when you've been told no, when you've been told no, you're not qualified, when you've been told no, I don't think we need you just yet, we found someone else, that doesn't mean you're not purposed. God wants to see how much you trust him. How much do you believe in what God spoke over your life? Are you going to believe the report of others, or are you going to believe the report of Christ Jesus, who has the final say? We know God has the final say over everything in our lives, but we have to trust God's timing. We have to believe, remain faithful, not easily be moved or shaken by our temporary. We know Proverbs 3:5-6 declares, it says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. And lean not to thine own understanding, and all thine ways acknowledge him, and he will make thy path straight. We have to trust God. We have to remain faithful. We have to remember the promises that God made to you and I, even after being told no so many times, even after being rejected, even after a few denials, many delays, disappointments. We know that God is still faithful. We have to believe and trust in God's timing, because God indeed has the final say. God promised us. He says, I know the plans. And God's plans are great. God doesn't just give us any old plans. God has purposed each and every one of us with greatness on the inside of us. We have to use it to the best of our ability. Even after we feel defeated, when we feel like we're not moving as quickly as we think we should in our purpose, and those great dreams and those goals and visions that God has so carefully orchestrated for you and I. We have to be determined to trust God even after we feel like we've taken one huge step only to be knocked back three. We have to trust God because He has the final say. It doesn't matter how it looks like right now. So often we get discouraged because we go by what we see and the right now. But God has purposed you for great things. I'm here to encourage someone to remember your promises. Remember your promises to God. You promised that you would trust Him. You promised that you would believe in His word. Continue to trust God. Continue to remain faithful and watch God progressively move you into your greater. Even though right now it looks like you're not moving as fast as you think you should, but we know slow and steady wins the race. You have to be determined to trust in God and all of His plans, even when it looks like His plans are not working out in your favor. You have to remain faithful in knowing that God's plan for your life is greater than any plan that you can ever imagine or fathom. God has great things in store for you, but you have to trust in God's plan because God has the final say and God's timing is perfect. I love you all so very much. This has been Monday's Motivational Minute. Remember, trust God's timing. God has the final say, even after it looks like things aren't moving as fast as you think they should, when it seems like your purpose is just at a standstill. Your hopes and dreams and heart's desires are not matching up to what you thought they should. God is still faithful. God wants to see just how much you're willing to trust Him and believe in His promises. Believe in God's promises on today. This is Inspirational Cafe. I love you all. Until next time, be blessed.